Finnegan to the far side, has Jamison, cuts it inside, has the first down, inside the 30 to the 25, taken down at about the 20-yard line. McCrory on the stop, Keith and McCrory, it'll be a first down for Fresno State.
Sherman Steptoe, cornerback number two for Tulsa, slipped down. And by the time he got back up on his pins, he was too late to get over there. You see number two, by that time he's back on his feet, but he had lost so much ground, and Jamerson takes it downfield.
Down play for Fresno State. Bulldogs have converted 34% of their third down opportunities this year. Pinniger pass taken. Fingertip catch by Marque Davis inside the 5-yard line. It'll be first and goal, Fresno State. Steven Spock at the H-back position. Rodney Davis up the middle. Touchdown, Fresno State.
Well, that's what you want to do. You want to send a message to a football team that has struggled. And that's a great drive, that third down pass, the key. And you can see Rodney Davis will have some room to operate.
We're going good offensively, fumbles the football, and now Tulsa with a chance to tie it with a score here. Richardson, it's the end around. This time it goes to Robbie Bryant, hit and dropped by Nick Burley.
I'll tell you, he was hit by Nick Burley. That was a tremendous hit as they brought Rombie Bryant around and an end around. And you can see why Nick Burley on a play like that's going to the Hula Bowl. I mean, he just held his ground and then delivered the blow. That was a big-time stick by Nick Burley.
Leads the team with 5 sacks, also leads in tackles for loss. That was his 11th of the season. The loss takes it back to the 14. Pitch to Richardson. Trying to get outside. The Bulldogs won't let it. Mark Daly in on the stop for Fresno State. James Sanders also went defensively for the Bulldogs.
Team speed. That's the difference between Tulsa right there and Fresno State.
Third down now for Tulsa. Kelly in the pass. Pressure from behind. Burley wraps him up. Incomplete. But Nick Burley wouldn't let him get the pass away. On 2nd and 5, Pinniger will throw. He's looking deep. Over the shoulder catch by Jamison, knocked out of bounds. Perfect pass out of the 30-yard line. Big game for Fresno State.
And Jermaine Jamison is a big play guy, big receiver who comes up with big plays. And it's been wonderful to watch his growth this year from the beginning of the season, and a marvelous long ball throw by Paul Pinniger.
Los Angeles on first down. Rodney Davis, big hole again. Steps across the 25, inside the 20, dragging defenders to about the 16-yard line. Need to get inside the 5-yard line. Pinniger, strike over the middle, touchdown, Jamison.
And a flag comes in late from the near sideline.
Pinniger's best passing game, 371 yards. That was against Boise State. Pass is complete. Marque Davis in stride to the 20-yard line.
Boy, that was a dart from Pinniger. I mean, earlier we saw him throw that high arcing long ball with touch. This is just the fastball. Get it there in a hurry. And that's just beating the defender with a great throw to Marque Davis.
Nothing, Fresno State. Killian still has the football, and Jason Stewart has Killian all the way back to the 6-yard line. Killian sets up in the shotgun. Here comes the pressure. He tries to dish it off, but it'll be picked up and incomplete. It was a little shovel pass. Mark Daly picked it up, and it was an incomplete pass. And Fresno State dodges another bullet. Jennings in motion to the near side this time. Hand off to Davis, up the middle, a big hole. Inside the 40, busts his way to about the 38-yard line before he's finally taken down by Alexander. And a fight over here on the near side.
I look up and somebody just leveled Marque Davis for Tulsa. Smith has gone berserk. Chad Smith, number 22. He's got to be careful. And you see Pat Hill acting as a policeman saying, guys, get out. get back to the sideline, the ones who aren't supposed to be here.
Both head coaches out on the field now.
Yeah, I want to cool these guys down. Play football, let's not get too emotional.
I had my binoculars on the ball carrier.
But there's one penalty on the player that came over and leveled Marque Davis. That's for sure. Where the other markers are, we're not sure.
Burns directing those heated comments to the official.
Keep in mind that play by Rodney Davis was a substantial gain for Fresno State. And that's where Robbie Beck of Rice hurt Tulsa last week. That quick hitter right up the middle. And boom, the same thing, Rodney, with that quick hitter. And he was downfield in a hurry. So the and hammered Marque Davis. I would imagine that first penalty against Fresno State, then the later one against Davis.
Davis again picks his way up the middle inside the 30, struggles forward to about the 25-yard line. That'll be about a 13-yard pickup and another first down, Fresno State.
Go to the laundry more often.
Huge holes being opened up by the Fresno State offensive line. There's another one. Davis inside the 15 to about the 12-yard line.
And again, this is a result of that accurate passing earlier. And they changed a little bit. They held back. And we're playing for the pass, not sending a lot of bodies, but here's that delay. Now they rush coming in on the quarterback and the perfect draw call to Rodney Davis.
Comes in motion, leaving Marque Davis. Pinniger will throw. Unloads it to Spock. The tight end, the H-back has it. Touchdown, Fresno State. Steven Spock coming out of the backfield.
That's a big touchdown for the Bulldogs penalty.
22, third down and goal. Pinniger, no pressure, dumps it off to Jennings. Gets a block from Davis. Inside the five, breaks a tackle, and out of bounds, just short of the goal line.
Well, the fireworks,
the rockets go off, but no, it's not a touchdown, but just short.
Well, this is all Jennings.
Watch the block there, though, by Davis.
Yeah, he did get the block, but this is great effort here. I mean, three, four Tulsa defenders missing because, again, the elusiveness, the spin move, they're just glancing off of him. And Tulsa, candidly, didn't do a very good job of wrapping him up. And you got to wrap up a guy like Adam Jennings.
Fourth and goal. Pinniger pushes. Waiting for a signal. There he is. Touchdown, Fresno State. 15. Be content to run out the clock, but they'll lose about four as Richardson had nowhere to go.
Eric Richardson.
Second and goal. Richardson. He runs into a wall, bounces outside, and he'll lose another yard. Jason Stewart for Fresno State in on the stop.
Once under 43 yards. Simpson the hold. Looks like that one has plenty of leg, and it's good.
So Asenas Berouhoff, who didn't even play football until junior college at Grossmont, and there was only used as a kickoff guy, is now 14 of 19 on field goals this season.
And again, earlier this week, one of the semifinalists for the Groza, which is named after Luke Groza, Hall of Fame kicker. And it's funny that they say semifinals because there's 20 kickers around the country that are still in the hunt for that award, but he's certainly a very good one.
Bulldogs show blitz, and it's Todd Garcia dropping Richardson for a loss inside the 20. Fourth down, Tulsa will go for it. Four receivers in. And Killian tried to take it himself. That didn't work. Jason Stewart dropped him for a loss of two. Davis finds an opening, and now here's a little foot race. Alexander tracks him down, but not before Rodney Davis gets inside the 37, right at the 37-yard line. That's where they will spot it.
Well, Rodney Davis will run to his right, and Stevenson, 68, with the big block to free him. Also, Shaq helping out. By the time Alexander finally pushed him out of bounds.
Killian again flushed out of the pocket, intercepted by Goodman.
Kyle Goodman, the sophomore, right along the sideline, anticipated, picked it off. And Fresno State will come out on offense and just kneel down to end this game.
The unit gets to play in the waning seconds and get an interception. And as you forecast, the knee down, and the Bulldogs have the game.
So now Pat Hill and the Bulldogs can start preparing for next Saturday's big game. The Nevada Wolfpack will be here. Nevada trying to make a little noise in the postseason bowl race as well.
That'll be two teams 5-5, and it really is a playoff game.